Hi everyone, the topic of this research is investigating and monitoring rural power transmission line and arable land types using geospatial techniques for sustainable development and life sustenance in Nigeria. Power supply in Nigeria is poor due to several challenges such as no access to energy, management problems and policy. Roads and power lines infrastructures are bad. Food insecurity is on the increase, and lives of Nigeria is at the peril of hunger. We need adequate data to be able to solve these geospatial problems. Real-time temporal monitoring is required to collect information for monitoring these challenges. Remote sensing and GIS is the only tool to solve these challenges. My name is Akpata Sylvester Bam Mifueya, a PhD candidate of the Department of Surveying and Geoinformatics, University of Nigeria Enugu Campus, a project coordinator, Red Force Nigeria Limited, on Nigeria Energy Support Project, NESP. I hold a double master's degree in remote sensing and GIS and geodesy and geodynamics from University of Nigeria, Enugu Campus and Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Awka. Transmission line, a network of energy that supply energy from one community to the other in Nigeria. My focus here is on the 33 and 11 kVA transmission line, which connects energy from the various substations across Nigeria to the consumers. For the performance of these energy supplies to be known, the locations of all transmission lines for this 33 and 11 kVA need to be identified and surveyed, so that the ones that are dilapidated, that are having infrastructural problems, could easily be documented and make available to the authority in charge of energy so that they could get it fixed. And as we all know, food insecurity is a global phenomenon. And as such, it is required that all arable land type that is used for crop production be identified, so that it could be well harnessed for sustainable agricultural practices to enhance crop production and food supply to people. Roads are a gadget for communication, as it connects various cities, villages, and rural communities together for business purposes and for transactional purposes. Many roads in Nigeria, especially in rural community, has never been constructed before and need to be constructed. This location of all these unconstructed roads need to be known and made available to the public, so that anyone who has the interest of fixing such road could easily deploy resources to those areas and get it fixed. More also, the few roads constructed that connected towns and city, a very interstate in Nigeria, has been dilapidated, and this has actually affected business activity between state in Nigeria. This location need to be known and made available to the public, so that whoever who have the capability and the capacity to get the road fixed could easily get access to information that will guide him or her to fix such road. Gathering data for 11 and 33 kVA transmission line geolocations, arable land type geolocation, road not constructed geolocations, and dilapidated road not constructed geolocations require a whole lot of resources and experience, including expertise, because these locations of such these such infrastructure required need to be known, and the reasons and attribute information known. Otherwise, ordinarily, satellite imagery can easily be used to check all this location and identify them. But now there are other attribute information that will describe those areas and the roads. Why the roads are not constructed? What is the problem? Who are the councillor in charge of those areas? Who are the concerned authority in charge of area that can easily assist? So, as such, a detailed method of getting it done is by using a survey method and GIS. The survey gets the geolocational data for all the 1133 kV, all the arable land time, then the roads network across the study area. While the GIS, which are all now embedded in just one phone, in a phone, cannot be used also to impute all the descriptions, the locations, the names, and the city, the town, the area, reasons why the infrastructures are not okay or bad can all be documented just using phone and a tablet. Aim of the study is to investigate and monitor roads, power transmission line, and arable land type using geospatial technique for sustainable development and life sustainability in Nigeria. The objective is to collect locational data for transmission line, roads, and arable land type using global mobile mapper installed on tablet. 2, to process all this acquired data using global mapper mobile software. 3, to map all the settlements that are off the power line transmission network using JOSON and ID software. 4, to develop a database for the data collected for the study. To achieve this enumerated objective, a methodological approach of data acquisition, data processing, and database design was carried out in the course of this study. A template layout was created for data acquisition, and a tablet and a phone was used to carry out data acquisition across the study area. Six teams were trained to be used to carry out this survey for the 1133 kVA, arable land type, and the road networks in the study area. The acquired data was exported to the global mobile mapper desktop version for data processes and analysis. The acquired data for 1133 kVA were converted to shape files, and the attribute information validated for database creation and analysis. The results of the created database were checked and validated for further analysis, while the off-grid settlement from the power transmission of 1133 kVA were mapped using JOSON and ID software with the use of Bing and Mazar imagery. You can query to generate results of interest from the database. If you are interested in getting detailed information about the 1133 kVA, you can query it from the database. If you are interested in getting information about the various arable land time, you can query it from the database. And if you are interested in getting the road network in the study area, both the constructed road and the not constructed road, the good road and the dilapidated road, you can query them and get it out. Then you can also get the geolocation of such information you are looking for, and you can easily deploy resources to go and get it fixed if you want to assist. Then areas The map produced from the study contains all the information required to fix road network in the study area, to fix energy in the study area, and to organize a sustainable agricultural practices in the study area. As you can see on the image display, you see all the network transmission line in red, indicating the 33 kVA motorable, while the green lines indicate 33 kVA not motorable. The settlement itself is shown on the map with the ones with tie roads and the one with no constructed road. With this information contained in the database, access can be made available to anyone who is interested and who wished to assist to fix the road network in Nigeria and to also construct roads to areas and locations where there are no roads, and to also help to provide necessary assistance that will increase crop production in the study area to enhance food security in the study area. Thank you for listening.